Hi everyone, it's Lena here, and in this short video, I'm excited to show you how to control Bitwig Studio with KeyLab Essential. Let's dive in. Bitwig comes with a dedicated KeyLab Essential MIDI script and protocol, which allows KeyLab Essential to be recognized instantly after launching it alongside your DAW. However, it's good to make sure to use the latest DAW versions to ensure the best KeyLab Essential integration experience. This means that you do not need to dive deep into the menu to set things up. It's done the moment you launch your DAW. Firstly, let's take a look at the main encoder. The main encoder allows you to navigate in the scenes, device, or mixer, and navigate in the item of the selected category while browsing through instruments or effects. By clicking on the main encoder, you can launch the first scene of the selection rectangle in the device or mixer and preview the sound or load the sound from the browser if you double-click. Next, we have the contextual buttons. There are four contextual buttons on the KeyLab Essential, and each of them has a unique function. Button number one opens or closes the browser, while button number two allows you to switch between device and mixer mode. Contextual button number three selects the previous track or category in the browser, while contextual button number four selects the next track or category in the browser. Moving on to the transport section, we have the play, stop, record, and loop buttons. These buttons are self-explanatory and allow you to control the playback and recording of your music. Next up, let's discuss the knobs and faders and the part button, which has an impact on what these control. In the device mode, the dimmed part button status means that KeyLab Essential knobs and faders control the first page of parameters, while the fully lit part button controls another page of parameters. This means that in this mode, you can take the advantage of all the Bitwig instruments and effects controls and tweak them directly from KeyLab Essential. Also, each time you press the part button, you cycle between parameter pages, and the KeyLab Essential display shows you the name and number of the page. Another functionality of these knobs and faders comes from the mixer mode, where the dimmed part button allows you to control tracks 1 to 8, while the fully lit part button controls a block of tracks 9 to 16. On top of that, knob 9 and fader 9 always control the volume and the pan of the selected mixer track. The pads on the KeyLab Essential are a powerful tool to use while working in Bitwig. In Bank A mode, the 8 pads correspond to the 8 clips of the 4 first tracks and 2 first scenes, starting from the clip selected. Bitwig Studio will display a 4x2 rectangle, and the top left corner matches the first clip of the first track. In this bank, you can launch clips with ease. In Bank B mode, the pads will simply send MIDI notes. This means that pressing the pads will trigger sounds coming from the device that is inserted on the track. It will be a great way to trigger and play drums using the Bitwig native drum machine device. Finally, if you're using Analog Lab, make sure you link the correct device, in this case KeyLab Essential MK3, in the MIDI settings of Analog Lab. You can enter analog lab mode by selecting the Arturia program directly from KeyLab Essential. When Analog Lab is selected, you can manage the plugin as you would do in a standalone, allowing you to navigate, browse, and select the sounds with ease. And that's it. Hopefully this video showed you just how easy and enjoyable it is to control your session using KeyLab Essential. For more detailed information on KeyLab Essential and how to use it, make sure to watch our dedicated video series on our channel. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.